Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy, and this is another session on probability. I hope what we have discussed about the probability in the previous lecture, you were able to understand it, and there is no confusion at all. And if you have no confusion, then we can proceed in this session as well. So let me discuss this probability we are going to discuss here. In last lecture, we have discussed about the sample space, favorable event, and definition of probability. Let me discuss few questions on the basis of that. Starting with some small questions, we will discuss some good questions as well. So first question is that, considering the very first question today, a bag contains five red and six black balls. A ball is drawn at random. What is the probability that ball is a red color? What is probability that the ball drawn is red in color, red ball? So out of the box, this is a bag and which contain some red balls and some black ball. Red balls are there. How many red balls? Five red balls. And apart from that, the other are black balls. Say black balls are there. How many black balls? Six black balls. So total number of balls in this bag is 11. So total number of balls is 11. Total number of balls in the bag is 6 plus 5, that is 11. So if anyone will draw one ball out of this 11, then anyone out of 11 may come out. So there are different type of 11 event, type of event can occur. Any one of them may come out. So total number of outcomes are 11. So in this question, NS is equal to 11. Sample space has 11 different type of event. Any one of them may come out. But your favorable is this red one only. So your favorable is how many? 5 of them are favorable. Your favorable is 5 out of them only. And therefore, probability of that event is, NF by NS. And therefore, we can write 5 by 11, and that will be answer of this question. So, because out of 11 balls, 5 of them, these 5 of them are favorable only, and their probability of event would be 5 by 11. Number of favorable event divided by total number of outcomes. So, in this way, one can solve this question. Now, write question 2. What is the probability of getting 2 heads when a coin is tossed, when a coin is tossed thrice. Right? This is the question. So when a coin is tossed thrice or 3 coins are tossed together, the total number of outcome will be 8. We have discussed this. So here, simple space has 2 raised to the power 3, that is 8 outcomes. In those, favorable outcomes are 2 head we want. So first time head, second time head, and tail may come. Or time itself failed, last two times head may come. So number of favorable outcomes are 3 only, and therefore probability of event is NF divided by NS, that is 3 divided by 8, and that will be the answer of this question. So wherever, although out of 8 outcomes, they have, this is the 8 outcomes, let me write, just remember this, HHH, HHT, HTH, and THH, and then TTH, and then THT, and then HTT, and finally TTT. So these are the 8 outcomes. Some student might be think that 3 heads, 2 heads they are asking, so they may calculate usually this one 2 head, this one 2 head, and they also count that this one has a 2 head also. But forget, don't forget, there are 3 heads and they ask about 2 heads only. 2 heads means exactly 2 heads. If they ask at least 2 head, then that will be also calculated. But because they have asked exactly 2 heads, it means these 3 are to be taken into consideration. So here the answer is 3 by 8, because that will not be taken into consideration. Only these 3 are favorable out of this 8, and therefore favorable outcomes are described only 3, and 3 by 8 will be the answer of this question. Now next question is, when a pair of dice is thrown together, when a pair of dice are thrown together, when a pair of dice are thrown together, what is probability to get sum of numbers on dice is 10. So this is the question, 10. The second part of the question is, sum is at least 10. The third part of the question can be, sum is at most 10. So these are the 3 different questions. When a pair of dice are thrown together, what is the probability to get sum of the numbers on dice is 10. To get sum of numbers on the dice is 10. The second part of the question is, sum is at least 10. The third part is, sum is at most 10. So 3 part of the questions that we have to discuss in one question only. So here what to do, since solution I can write, a pair of dice is thrown together, it means simple space has 6 square, that is 36. We have learned that when a dice is thrown n times or n dice are thrown together, the total number of outcome in simple space will be 6 raised to the power n. So here this is 6 square, because a pair of dice are thrown, 6 square, that is 36. 36 is the total simple space. Now the favorable outcomes are what? What will be the favorable outcomes for question number 1? The sum can be 10. In what are the pairs of 2 numbers which will be available on dice, so that their sum is 10. So keeping in the mind, we can have 4, 6. If one dice has 4, another dice has 6, then their sum is 10. And 6, 4 can be also possible. 5, 5 can be also possible. Is there any other number which is possible? Can you say 7, 3 is also 10? Yes, 7, 3 is also 10, but 7 is not available on dice. So you can't pick number like this, 7, 3, 3, 7, 8, 2, 2, 8, 9, 1, 1, 9. They are also making 10, but this is not possible because 7, 8 and 9 are not available on dice. So only 3 possibilities are there. NF is 3, NS is 36, we have already calculated, and therefore probability of event is equal to NF by NS, that is 3 by 36, which is 1 by 12. And so 1 by 12 will be the answer of this question. As far as concerned with the second part of the question, what they are asking, in second part, they ask that sum is at least 10. If you are asking to your father that please give me at least 1000, what does it mean? If he will give you 1500, will you be angry or you will be happy? Of course you will be happy. He is giving you 500 more than what you are expecting. So, he will give you 500 more rupees. You are asking, give me at least 1000, means 1000 and more is acceptable, but less than 1000 you not accept because your purpose will not be going to solve. So, here at least 10, sum is at least 10, means sum can be 10 or more than 10. More than 10, what can be the maximum sum? Maximum sum can be 12, because both dice can give the maximum output, that is 6 on one dice and 6 on other dice, then 6 plus 6 can be 12, and therefore maximum output will be 12, and minimum, what they are expecting? At least 10. So there are favorable outcomes can be, sum can be 10 or more than 10, so sum can be 4, 6, 6, 4, 5, 5, this is the possibility for 10. Now more than 10, that can be 11 also. What way in which 11 can come? 6, 5 and 5, 6, 6, 5 and 5, 6, that can come 11. And also 12 may come when both the dice give maximum output, that is 6, 6. So this can come. So here number of favorable outcomes are 6. Sample space remains same. NS is 36. So therefore probability of event is NF by NS, and therefore this is 6 by 36, which is 1 by 6, and that will be the answer of this question. Now considering the third part. Here, sum is at most 10, means what? Sum is at most 10, it means you want maximum sum up to 10, more than 10 sum is not expected, not favorable for you. More than 10, that is 11 and 12 is not favorable for you. Except 11 and 12, everything will be, every sum will be accepted, but 11 and 12, when come, it is not expected from you and you will not accept it, that is not favorable. So in case, here favorables are, minimum sum can be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So all these are favorable, and different combination of getting 7 or 6 or 5 or 9, it would create some problems, it will create some, take some time in which you will be able to calculate it. So it will be better that when list of favorable is too long, find those which are not favorable and then subtract it from 1. So because total probability happening and not happening, total probability of that event will be 1. If you are saying that there is a 70% chance that I get through this year from prelims examination, it means there is a 30% chance that you won't be able to get through. So there is a possibility, and here we don't want so favorable, not favorable event can be described as f to the power bar. And what we don't, not favorable, that 11 and 12 are not favorable. So 6, 5, 5, 6 and 6, 6 are not favorable. So number of not favorable outcomes are 3. So probability which is not favorable, that is also E bar, is equal to 3 by 36, that is 1 by 12. 1 by 12 is the probability of non-favorable events, and therefore probability of an event is 1 minus probability of E naught, that is 1 minus 1 by 12, and that is 11 by 12. So 11 by 12 is the answer of this question. Or in other way, alternate, you may think like that out of 36, 3 of them are not favorable, so remaining 5 are favorable, 33 are favorable, and therefore probability of event can be described as 33 divided by 36, that is 11 by 12. So in this way you may also answer the question, right? But one thing you remember, that whenever the list of favorable is too long, find those which are not favorable and subtract it out of 1. In this way, you will be able to solve the questions quickly. Okay? Now, let me describe some other questions where question is, what is probability that a leap year, a general year means non-leap year. General year means non-leap year has 53 Monday. What is probability that in general year, that is non-leap year, has 53 Monday? To solve these questions, do you know how many Monday and Sunday in a year? In a year, do you know how many days? Yes, you know that a general year has 365 days. So in 1 year, there are 365 days, right? So that can be written as 52 into 7 plus 1. 52 into 7 is 364 plus 1. That is 52 week plus 1 day, right? So in 1 year, there are 52 week and 1 day. You can check in your mobile or calendar where the week distribution is there, 52 week and 1 day. This is the solution of this question, right? 52 week and 1 day. In every week, there is 1 Monday. Do you think in any particular week, there is more than 1 Monday? Do you think like that? No, no, it is not possible. Every week has only 1 Monday. Or do you think there is a week in which there is no Monday? No, it is also not possible. So every week has not more, not less, but there is only 1 Monday, exactly. Not only Monday, but all days fall exactly 1 and only 1. So in each week, there is 1 Monday. So 52 week, there will be certainly 52 Monday. 1 day left, if that would be Monday, then there will be 53 Monday, otherwise it won't be. So what extra 1 day that is left, what is the possibility that what this day would be? So this day would be maybe Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, right? Friday and Saturday and Sunday. These are the possibility that this extra day can have 7 values. It can fall on for any days, you know. But what we are interested is NS is equal to 7, but your favorable is only Monday. Your favorable is Monday only. Number of favorable is 1, and therefore probability of an event is what? Probability of event is NF by NS, and therefore this is 1 by 7, and that will be answer of this question. So 1 by 7 would be the probability that a year has 53 Monday. 52 we have 52 Monday. This is nothing special about this, nothing official about it. But if this last day would be a fall on Monday, then there will be 53 Monday and your wish will be complete. Otherwise, it will remain incomplete. So, pray with the God that this last day would be Monday. But just by praying this, it is not possible, because out of the 7 days, any one of them may come out your message Monday. So might be possible that God will help you, and in that case this would be your favorable one out of 6 out of 7, and therefore probability will be 1/7. Now, one related question. Question number 6. What is probability that a leap year has 53 Sunday? Leap year has 53 Sunday. What is the questions and how to deal with such situation? What is the probability that a leap year has 53 Sunday? Again, the solution will be in similar way. What are that? 1 year is 366. One leap year. I am talking about not a general year, but one leap year. Leap year has 366 days, right? That is 52 week plus 2 days, right? Last 2 days. So here the last 2 days, 52 week must have 52 Sunday, and last 2 days, if any one of the last 2 days fall on Sunday, then there would be 53 Sunday overall, isn't it? So last 2 days can be fall Sunday or Monday, Sunday or Saturday, then it is possible that one of them is Saturday and one of them is Sunday. In that case, one Sunday will come. If Sunday, Monday will come, then also Sunday will come. So last 2 days can have possibility, that is the possible outcomes are for last 2 days, maybe Sunday, Monday, maybe Monday, Tuesday, maybe Tuesday, Wednesday, maybe Wednesday, Thursday, maybe Thursday, Friday, you know, maybe Friday, Saturday, right? And maybe Saturday or Sunday. So this is what the possibility. Out of the 7 possibility, what is favorable for you? Your favorable is you want Sunday under any circumstances. So when Sunday, Monday will come, then also Sunday will come. If Saturday, Sunday will come, then also Sunday will come. So NS is equal to 7 here. Simple space, the number of items in simple space would be 7. And favorable cases are, here favorable cases are Sunday, Monday or Saturday, Sunday. That is possible. So out of them, 2 of them are favorable. So probability of favorable outcome would be 2/7. Probability of advantage NF/NS, and that will be 2/7, and that will be the answer. So in general year, probability is 1/7, but in case of leap year, this will be 2/7. So accordingly, you can calculate. Now, if someone asks, very interesting question, I have asked many times in my civil services classes, and the students usually confused about that, and they won't answer properly. Many times, even in a particular class, there may be 500 or 600 or 700 and sometimes 800 students in my class where they not able to answer the questions properly. Once I asked in the last week only that what is the probability that a leap year has 52 Sunday. So they say, sir, one. I asked how this is possibility that there will be one. Sir, every week has Sunday, so 52 week must have 52 Sunday, and it is certainly 52 Sunday would be there. So the probability of that question would be 1. Do you think this is the right answer? Do you think that this is a true answer? No, it is not a true answer. And what they have answered me, In last week even I have asked, and there was 800 students, among more than 500 are engineers, but still they haven't answered properly, except few, one or two students at the end when they have given two or three answers, and I remind them that they have given wrong answer, then after a lot of thinking they have given the right answers. But what is this? Will you answer properly? No, no? It is difficult, no? You will also say, yes sir, every Sunday there is 52 week, 52 Sunday will be definitely there. So this is a sure event and probability would be 1. No. There might be possibility that 53 Sunday also. There are two type of possibility. Either there will be 52 Sunday or there will be 53 Sunday. So in leap year, there is a two type of possibility. If there is not 53 Sunday, then there will be 52 Sunday. Suppose last 2 days come any one of the remaining 5, then there will be only 52 Sunday. In that case, there would not be 53 Sunday. So to get 52 Sunday, to ask for 52 Sunday, your favorable outcomes are all 5 except these 2. Right now, so in that case favorable outcomes are 5 only, and probability of that event would be 5 by 7, because out of 7 outcomes, 5 of them are favorable, so in that case probability would be 5 by 7. So if someone asks, what is the probability that a leap year has 52 Sunday, then you don't say that probability is 1. What you will say that? Probability is 5 by 7. Because a leap year can have 52 Sunday and 53 Sunday as well. There are two possibilities. If there is not 53 Sunday, then certainly there will be 52 Sunday. Otherwise, if there is a 52 Sunday, then there cannot be 53 Sunday. Both things cannot happen together. Either 52 Sunday only or 53 Sunday only. So if there is not 53 Sunday, there must be 52 Sunday. These are called complementary events which both cannot happen together. So if probability of getting 53 Sunday is 2 by 7, then probability of not getting 53 Sunday, that is 1 minus 2 by 7, that can be also written as 1 minus 2 by 7, that is also 5 by 7. So probability of E naught is, in that case E is this, E naught is 5 by 7. E naught is what? Probability of 53 Sunday getting, not getting 53 Sunday, and not 53 Sunday, then 52 Sunday only. But if someone asks, what is the probability of getting 50 Sunday in a year? What will say? 1? No. It is not possible for 50 Sunday exactly. So in that case, answer will be 0. It is impossible event. It is null event. It is not possible that a year has only 50 Sunday. What is the point? So this is what the way in which you can answer the questions. In next class, we will discuss some more questions on the different aspects of playing cards and related questions. And thereafter, we will discuss when more than one item is drawn, then what will happen the probability and addition rule of probability as well. So thank you very much for watching. Keep watching the videos and subscribe our channel. Also, visit my website www.arvindsingh.com. Thank you. Thank you very much. All the best. Thanks.